Good evening. I hope that you've had a great day today. As you can see, I'm with my daughter Turner tonight, and we're going to share from the book of Esther. Now, we actually talked about Esther, I think it was last night, actually. We talked about it in about Esther chapter 4, verse 14, the second part of it, and how cool it is that Mordecai gives Esther this challenge, and we just love that. But tonight, I want us to go a little bit deeper with that. And in case you don't know the story, I'll kind of give you a brief synopsis, but essentially, the king of Persia at the time has gotten rid of his wife because she has disrespected him. Okay, so he gets rid of Vashti and he holds this big beauty pageant to see who his next wife is going to be. And his next wife, he chooses a lady named Esther, who is a Jew. Now, her uncle Mordecai had raised her and she is now in the palace, but the king does not know she's a Jew. Okay, and Haman, one of the king's advisors, he gets really ticked off at Mordecai because Mordecai refuses to bow down to him. And so Haman comes up with a plan to kind of get back at Mordecai. And he says, I'm not just going to kill you. I want to kill all your people, all the Jewish people. He comes up with a plan to completely annihilate them. Okay. And the king goes for it. And in chapter 4, we see Mordecai going to Esther saying, hey, you've got to stand up on our behalf. You have to do this. And that's what we talked about last night. In chapter 4, verse 14, you can look too if you want to, sister. The end part, it says here, and who knows, this is Mordecai talking. He says, but who knows, Esther, but that you have come to your royal position for such a time as this. And that's so encouraging to know that God has a plan for us and there's a purpose for us in where we live and what we do and all this. God has a plan and he wants us to be a part of it. But tonight, I really want us to go backwards to that chapter 4, verse 14a, okay? Because Mordecai tells Esther she has to go and talk to the king and try to get this taken away. And it's really neat here because Esther says, I can't do it, Uncle Mordecai. I cannot do this because if I go to the king without him asking for me to come, he will kill me. That's what the law says. And Mordecai responds to her in this. He says, do not think that because you are in the king's house, you alone of all the Jews will escape. Mordecai tells her, he says, Esther, sweetheart, you are going to die too. You are a Jew. We're all going to die. Now, this next line, I love it. And he says here in verse 14, he says, for if you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will arise from another place. Ah, that's what I love right there. Mordecai is going to give this great challenge to Esther saying, for such a time as this, God has placed you there and I want you to have the boldness. I want you to have the strength. But he says, if you don't, God is still going to accomplish his purpose. And I want to challenge you tonight when you're talking to your kids and even in your own heart, I want to encourage you to have the faith that Mordecai did. This faith to say that God is so good and so powerful, and yet he's still giving me an opportunity to play a key role in this world for him. Yet if I choose not to, he's still going to carry out his purposes. But why would we want to turn away that opportunity? Esther's not going to turn away that opportunity. In fact, she's going to ask them to please fast for her and pray. And we'll get into that actually later because I'm just so enthralled by Esther at this point in time. But I just want to challenge you tonight to continue to have faith that God is in control, to be grateful that he's choosing to allow us to be a part of his bigger picture. And I'm asking you to have that boldness and faith to do what he's called you to do. Will you please pray with me? Lord God, we love you so much. We are so grateful that you have poured out your love on us and your grace on us to allow us to be a part of your bigger plan. And Lord, I thank you for the example of Mordecai and his faith that he has to say that Esther has this opportunity, but even if she doesn't, God is still in control. And Lord, I thank you for that example. And I pray for each one of us tonight that's watching or our kids that are listening. Lord, I pray that we will have that same faith to know that you are in complete control. And yet you're gracious enough to give us a part of it. We love you, Father. May we have good rest tonight. May we wake up refreshed, renewed, and ready to go. Lord, may our lives be just exemplified by us being servants for you. In your Son, Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you. Good night.